Pastor Joseph Adenuga is my name, welcoming you to this presentation. The title of this presentation is Power Over Satan. In the book of Luke chapter 10 and verse 19, the Bible says, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions, and all the powers of the devil, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." Jesus is telling us in this verse that you and I have power over the devil. He said, "Behold, I give unto you power." You have power. Power has been given unto you. Power has been given unto you to overcome every force of evil, every force of wickedness, every force of Satan, every force of sickness, every force of disease. You have power to tread upon them. And to tread upon something means to walk over it, to survive it, to overcome it. You have power to overcome problems. You have power to overcome difficulties. You have power to overcome evil. You have power to overcome financial crisis. You have power to overcome every form of wickedness that any enemy from the pit of hell may array against you. I want you to know that three important things I want you to know. Number one, all power belongs to Jesus. Matthew chapter 28 verse 18, Jesus came and said unto them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given unto me. Go ye therefore." All power in heaven and on earth has been given to our Lord Jesus Christ. And he is commissioning us to go because of this. Because of the fact that the power has been given to Jesus and to Jesus alone. Amen. So the first thing you have to understand is that all power belongs to Jesus. God has put all things into the hands of Jesus. God has put all things into the hands of Jesus. I look into my Bible in the book of John, chapter 5. You can open with me the book of John, chapter 5, chapter 3, verse 35. John, chapter 3, verse 35. It said, "The Father loved the Son and had given all things into his hand." All things are put into the hands of the Son of God, Jesus. And Jesus is giving you and I the power. He said, "Behold, I give unto you power." You have to understand that Jesus Christ is the power of God. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 24, we are told, Jesus Christ is the power of God and the wisdom of God. You want to see the power of God. You want to know the power of God. You want to experience the power of God. Jesus Christ is the power of God. He is the wisdom of God. He is the anointing of God. He is the grace of God. Hallelujah. You have to understand that in him are hid all the treasures of wisdom. Colossians chapter 2 verse 3. In Jesus are hid all the treasures of wisdom and understanding. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 2 verse 9 says, "In him dwell all the fullness of the Godhead bodily," in Jesus Christ. The fullness of God is dwelling, tabernacled in Jesus. He is the brightness of the glory of God. Hebrews chapter 1 from verse 2 and 3. He is the brightness of the glory of God. You want to see the glory of God? It's in Jesus. The power of God is in Jesus. And this power was put into the gospel of Jesus. The power of God has been embedded, has been put into the gospel. Romans chapter 1 verse 16 says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek." The power belongs to Jesus, and that power has been given to you, and that power is in the gospel of Jesus Christ. So as many as received him, received power. John chapter 1 verse 12. He said, as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. If you have received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, if you are a Christian, born again, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, then you have power. Acts chapter 1 verse 8 says, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me. You have power. You are not ordinary. The gospel of Jesus Christ is the power of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18. The gospel of Jesus is the power. When you have the gospel, you have the power. When you understand the gospel of Jesus Christ, you are keyed into the power that made the heavens and the earth. By accepting Jesus into your life as your Lord and Savior, you are initiated into power. It is a power play. The gospel of Jesus is the gospel of power. And anybody who is connected to the gospel with faith is connected to the everlasting source of power. Hallelujah. If you are connected to the gospel of Jesus, you are connected to the gospel of power. You are not left powerless. You are equipped with the power that created the heavens and the earth once you are connected with the gospel of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of Mark chapter 16, he said, this gospel of Jesus, let's read it. Mark chapter 16, I open to it here, from verse 15. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He that believeth not shall be damned. And this sign shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall drink deadly things. They shall not hurt them. They shall take up serpents. And they shall lay their hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Lord is good. The power of God is in the gospel of Jesus. Anyone that is keyed to the gospel is keyed into the power. Hallelujah. And this power has been given unto you. Luke chapter 10 verse 19. Behold, I give unto you power. Hallelujah. Micah chapter 3 verse 8. I am full of power by the Spirit of God. You are full of power. Say it with me. I am full of power by the Spirit of God. I am full of power by the Spirit of God. My friend, you are full of power, even you. Go and discover this power. Begin to use it. Begin to use this power against the enemy. Begin to use this power against the devil. Begin to use this power against your problems. Begin to use this power against financial crisis. Begin to use this power against every family problem. Everything that troubles you is in trouble because of the power that you carry. 1 John chapter 1, verse chapter 4, verse 4. He said, you have got little children and you have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you. There is power in you. Hallelujah. It is well with you. I'm going to come to you again. And through this presentation, one of these days, watch out. My name once again is Adenuga Sunday Joseph, pastor of Success Dimension Church, Ibadan, Nigeria. God bless you. It is well with you. In Jesus' name. Amen.